Hey guys, it's Hollie. Now that I'm 21 years old, I thought I would make this video about my experiences on Britain's Got Talent when I was 10 years old, 10 years ago. Okay, so this is where it all started for me. So I didn't get told much. They took me in, they were like, oh, we're gonna do some rehearsals here, we're gonna change your song, don't like this song, don't like that song. But they didn't really tell me how much like the newspapers would affect me and how there would be people like at my front door, like just with cameras, and there would be people taking pictures through my window. Like as a 10-year-old girl, that's really weird to me. I was immediately taken out of school, so when the show aired, it was like this for me. I didn't realize how big it would be. It was quite a big year. It was Susan Ball's year, it was diversity's year. We had all the cool big people. So I do want to say though that I think now that since what happened with me on Britain's Got Talent as a child happened, that they've changed the way they deal with children on the show. Another thing which quite got to me as a child was that these people in the tabloids and the newspapers, they were like making up stories that I'd never said. So I would say something on the phone, they would ask me questions and I'd be like, I don't know. And then they'd be like, oh, can you say this to me? And I was like, okay, sure. So I would repeat what they said to me and then they would write down that I said it. So it's actually crazy what the British newspapers are like. So a lot of the things like probably you read that I said, I never said. Like I think they said that I said Simon Carr was a bully, and I don't think I ever said that. And if I did say it, oh my gosh, I remember I was on the phone to a woman, whichever newspaper wrote that, she was going, go on, say Simon Carr was a bully. And I was like, no. And she was like, go on, say he was a bully. And I swear, I was like, okay, Simon Cowell's a bully. And then bam, it was like all over the news, like front page, Hollie Steele says Simon Cowell's a bully. And I was like, no. And so that really upset me. Just things like that leading up to the semi-final, where of course, like I cried live on national television. So I never had stage fright before Britain's Got Talent. Like I love singing. I loved doing everything, musical theatre, and for some reason, just before, maybe about a week before the semi-finals, I started getting the worst stage fright, like freaking out, like basically anxiety, but no one told me that it was anxiety. I would say, oh, I have this thing where I keep like swallowing when I get nervous. I'm like, and like he was swallowing. So I kept telling people and they were like, oh, don't worry, it'll go away, don't worry, it's fine. Anyway, I guess that's what people thought was a good idea with a child. If they have anxiety, just tell them to put it to the back of their minds. But it didn't really work with me, especially as I would say I was quite a grown-up child, as in what I wanted to do. I knew I wanted to do musical theatre and I pushed to do that. Okay, so yeah, cut to the semi-final. I did not forget my words, as everyone puts in the newspapers. I did not forget the words. I had a panic attack on stage. I think if you watch the video, I haven't really watched it properly because it's quite an ordeal for me to watch. But if you watch it, there's, I think there's like 3 points. So there's the first point where I'm like, oh no, this isn't going perfect. There's a second point where I stop and I'm like, and then somehow I managed to regain the strength to continue singing. I mean, it's quite a big deal, especially for a 10-year-old, and this is what she wants to do. But what I want to do. And then the third time, I messed up again. I started getting this anxiety where I could, like, swallow it. And then I gave up. I was like, that's it. I've ruined it. I've ruined everything. I'm so angry with myself. I wasn't allowed my mum backstage, which I think is a bit silly. But now they've changed the rules that you are allowed your mum backstage or one person with you backstage. So that would have really helped me calm my nerves if I had her backstage. But my mum like ran. She was at the top. I think she was at the top. I'm not too sure. It was all a massive blur. But she was somewhere in the audience. And I remember she ran towards me and I was like, mummy! So yeah, and then luckily the judges, I'm so thankful for them, they let me sing again. Because if they hadn't have let me sing again, I don't think I would be singing now. So I'm so thankful. And I remember this before going on the second time, because I got the second chance, I was doing, has anyone seen High School Musical? I can't remember which one it is. I think it's the first one. And she goes, ma, ma, ma. And because I've watched High School Musical, I mean, that's how young I was like, okay, I'll calm myself down. I did some of my own meditation by doing my High School Musical, and then I went on stage and my mouth was so dry from the adrenaline that I didn't need to swallow. So great. So that, it went okay, and I guess it was a bit shaky, the vocals weren't that good, but I mean, I can't believe I did that. Still to this day, I look at it and I go, wow, like, that is one strong kid. So yeah. Oh, I also wanted to add that the song that I sang in the semi-final, I just read my notes, the song that I sang in the semi-final wasn't a song that I'd ever heard of before. So I wanted to sing Wishing You Were Somehow Here Again, which I got to sing in the final, and then I wanted to sing Nessun Dorma, like a massive opera song, like bam, I'm here, because I knew I could sing it. I was like, I'm so strong enough. And they said no, they were like, no, you can't sing that. And the only reason why I think they said no is because I was definitely able to sing it, was that they didn't want me to win. And it's nothing against Britain's Got Talent, like they don't fix it, but it's sort of like the song choices are fixed. Like, I couldn't sing a big opera song, so they gave me Edelweiss, which I'd never heard of before, and it was obviously from the musical The Sound of Music, but I'd never heard of it, and they gave it me, I want, 2 weeks before. And I mean, as an adult I could learn a song 2 weeks before, but as a child, no. Like, I was thinking, oh, I hate this song, I hate this song so much, every time I sang it. And I would tell my singing teachers that they gave me that I really don't like this song, and they're like, no, you're really good, come on, just sing it. And every time I'd be like, Edelweiss, Edelweiss, like, I hated it. So I guess that's another thing which added to the stage fright, because I didn't like the song. So after the show had happened, I've never been diagnosed, and still to this day I think I have it, post-traumatic stress disorder from the show. I loved singing before, and now I was getting the worst fright whenever. So I did the tour, and the Britain's Got Talent tour, and every time I went on stage I was like breathing really heavy, and there was times like I was just about to go on stage and I would run, and the producer would be like, no, Hollie, you have to go on the stage. And my mum would be like, Hollie, you don't have to do this, we can go home. But I was always like, no, I want to do this. And I think I want to make that clear, because everyone always thinks my mum was pushy or something, but if you look at it, I'm always like, no, I want to do this. And whatever, my mum did whatever I wanted to do. She was like so supportive. She was always like, okay, Hollie, obviously within reason, she wouldn't let me just be like, I want to do this, I want to do that, but she really supported what I wanted to do with my career at 10 years old. And she always listened to me and always said, like, do what's best for your health. But I was always like, no, I want to do this. So yeah, PTSD, PTSD. Great, Hollie. I sort of lost the love for singing, the passion for singing, and it wasn't because I didn't enjoy singing, it was because every time I went to sing, I would put myself through so much trauma to just sing, and then after I sang, I was like, oh my god, that was easy, like, why am I freaking out, sort of thing. Yeah, so after the show, there was things on YouTube, and like, my friends, they would just say things like, oh, haha, you were so funny how you cried. And then there would be people bullying me, like, oh, what a bitch sort of thing, and what spoiled brat. And obviously these get to me. I'm sat there like reading it, like, oh, like, haha, that person's nice to me. And then all of the other comments were nasty ones, and then it obviously got to my self-esteem, and I thought I was crap, like a really bad singer. And because these people were saying that, and I again thought I was a bad person, so it made me not want to sing, it made me not want to do things. So it sort of like went under the radar. Everyone would always ask me, Hollie, why aren't you doing things, why aren't you releasing music? And I just wanted to say to them, well, no one appreciates what I do, or no one actually likes me. I would always want to say, or like, even my fans, I used to think, they don't actually like me, they're just supporting me because they think I'm the underdog, because there would be all these other child stars who had lots of like a big support system from like the music industry, whereas I had none because of obviously what happened on the show. So I always felt like, no one actually wants to hear me sing, I'm not that good, so I'm just gonna stop. So I went under the radar, and I thought, if I get better, then in 10 years time, now, lol, in 10 years time, like, I can show people that I'm a completely different person, even though I was a sweet young child and I wasn't a bad person. And I wanted just to show people, like, guys, like, I don't know why you're ever mean to me, but That's what I was thinking at that age anyway. So I went under the radar, and even to this day, I still like to be a bit under the radar because I don't like it when people attack me. And I feel like it's something which is obviously inevitable on the internet and something that I have to get over. So yeah, it gave me that in my mind. It affected me in lots of ways. But yeah, so now 10 years later, going on from what I just said, it sort of hit me that the reason why I've always been under the radar and never posting things and always been a bit like, why am I doing this sort of thing, is just fear. Fear has been like running my life and my career for a good 10 years. Like, well, obviously for a good 10 years. I'm only 21, but my career started so young. So yeah, it's been running it, and it's time that I feel like I should overcome that and really work on my mental health. I mean, I'm quite a happy person, luckily, thankfully. And I always am so appreciative of what life has given me. But there's always that thing where I'm like, oh, I'd rather not sing. I'd rather just sit here. But now it's just fight through that fear. Do the things that you don't want to do. And that's what I want to say to you guys. So is there something that you are stopping yourself from doing because you have a fear? Is it like skydiving or starting a YouTube channel? I'm doing this now. I've already had a YouTube channel. But starting it up again, or singing like me, or is it dancing, or is it the big job that you want to do? You're just like, I'm not good enough. And what I want you to say to yourself is say, I'm good enough, I'm capable, I can do this, and I'm gonna do it. So yeah, and that's all I wanted to say today. And love you guys, and I'm probably gonna say something else when I remember. Confidence is not they will like me. Confidence is I will be okay if they don't like me. I would love to know your guys' thoughts on this video, and if any of you guys practice mindfulness, I mean, it really helps me become a happier person and really think about why I'm letting my emotions or my fears rule my life. So I love you guys so much, and have a wonderful week or evening or day or wherever you are in the world, and sending all the positive vibes, and keep smiling. Mwah. Bye! Confidence. Oh wow.